Not clickbait, live footage, the emotional, cringeworthy life hacks. Did I get you to click the video yet? If you've been following my channel for a while, then you know that at 19 years old, my first year of college, I became a published writer. To this day, that is still a crazy sentence to be able to say. I was published in Bella Grace Literary Magazine in 2015, not just once, not twice, but four times. Specifically for this video though, I want to focus on the publication that started out as being my first college essay assignment, because I think it's a really cool concept. My first college assignment is now a published piece of work in Bella Grace Magazine, and it was sold nationwide across Barnes & Nobles and bookstores alike, which is a crazy thought to me. I honestly am still in shock years later. It doesn't get old, it really doesn't. I never really talked about this publication because I definitely worked up my very first publication for valid reasons. It was super exciting as a writer to be published and to be able to share that with you at such a young age, and I did that a lot. But what I didn't really talk about was my third publication, which was a college essay titled Begin Again. Way back freshman year, my advisor, who I also had as a professor one semester, asked the class to go home and write 1 to 2 pages describing a location anywhere in the world. Since this was our first assignment, it was just to get us practicing writing, practicing using descriptive language, and focus on imagery. I remember I got this assignment back from the TA, and he told me that this is the type of work that they expect students to get out at the end of the semester after the class. So I felt very proud of myself that that first assignment already left such a great impression on him. So I decided to take it further, tweak it a little bit, perfect it, and submit it again to be published in Bella Grace Magazine. Since I had already had so much luck with 2 previous publications with this magazine already, let me know if you want to see a video of me reading those first publications, because like I said, I talked about my first publication, but I never read to you what was actually published. I never shared specifically what was in there, so if you didn't purchase it or see it in the store, I think it'd be really cool to kind of open up this publication, which is my very, very first one, my baby, and do a little reading of those. Actually, I probably will anyway, but let me know down below if you think that's a good idea. Give this video a thumbs up too, let me know. But this video is all about my first college assignment, becoming a published essay, and we're gonna read it today because I think that would be fun. Off camera, I'm currently multitasking again, and I'm uploading a vlog to my vlog channel. Make sure that you subscribe to my vlog channel. I'm currently uploading my Ulta unboxing video, which will be going up on Tuesday after this video goes up. I just have to say, because I don't say in the vlog, that I am very happy with my new products. In fact, my face is covered in it, so that's why my winged eyeliner looks so awful. I'm obsessed with this lip color, blush, and highlighter. So if you're curious what products they are, go watch the vlog, subscribe to that channel, and while you're at it, make sure to subscribe to this channel, because we really are like one big family over here with lots of love to go around, and it's never too late to join. All you have to do is hit subscribe. And don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you enjoy, because it really does help. This publication of Bella Grace came out around winter time. It was their winter issue, and I think this essay that they decided to publish really reflects that time of the year because it's called Begin Again. Just kidding, it's called To Be Born Again, LOL. Anyway, this is what it looks like, To Be Born Again, words by Michaela Smontree. It's 3 pages long, and I hope that you enjoy. To be born again. It's almost like a human heart, the way it never stops beating. For even when you wake from within the thin hotel sheets, sweat sticking to your skin like honey because you had a nightmare, in the stillness of your dark room, there is sound. Whether it's the 4-inch heels strutting 8th Avenue while attempting to balance skim lattes, or the instrument case placed on the sidewalk as it fills up with silver and copper, someone else is wide awake too, but most are not awake because of a nightmare like you are. They're awake because they're dreaming. Here, it doesn't matter where you come from. It's all about where you are going, who you want to become, and what you want to change. I sit on the metal bench below the streets and watch the strobes of lights shudder by me. The screeches of sudden halts cause creatures with tails the size of serpents to scamper, while a few lay motionless underneath the tracks. I have missed my morning train. No one else around me is sitting, for one does not come here to remain in one place. One comes here to keep moving, to make it to a further destination. I believe Kurt Vonnegut says it best in Bluebeard when he says, "Nowhere has the number 0 been of more philosophical value than in the United States." And when the train plunged into a tunnel under New York City, with its lining of pipes and wires, I was out of the womb and into the birth canal. That's what everybody wants, isn't it? A second chance? A new beginning? To be born again? The lights of the passing cars and tall office buildings pulse through the city like blood through veins. For even in the middle of the night, there is comfort and there is light. You stand at the tiny window your hotel room came with, listening to the sound found in the stillness of your room after a nightmare, and you realize that even though you are a stranger, alone in your own universe, this city is a mother. And then at the bottom of the page it says, Michaela Simuntri, a Minneapolis native, is currently studying English at a teeny college in Ohio. She creates original content and shares her writing through visual poetry on her YouTube channel. Hey, youtube.com/MichaelaSimuntri. She can be found buried deep within Tumblr or a stack of good books. And that is how my first college assignment became a published piece of writing sold nationwide in a literary magazine. I wrote that piece about New York City because I was very upset that my long childhood goal of moving to New York after high school fell through, that I couldn't afford it, that I ended up in Ohio, and that was kind of like my ode to New York, a reason why I love it. I wanted to share the highlights of the city that I fell in love with so many times visiting. As much as I disliked that professor, I do have to thank her for giving me that assignment, because that assignment gave me that piece of writing, and that piece of writing gave me a publication and a magazine sold in bookstores with my name in it. It also gave me something to check off of my bucket list that I never thought I would check off, be published, and it's a really cool feeling. I hope that this inspired you. I'm definitely refreshed with new inspiration at the moment just by going back and reflecting on something that happened to me in the past, because now I remember anything can happen, and it's really crazy to think about how my freshman year of college writing that, you know, it changed my life, it became published, and now I get to share it with you and an infinite amount of people. I can't help but smile. I hope that you enjoyed this video. If you did, be sure to give it a thumbs up to let me know. Comment down below with what you thought and if I should read my very first publications, which include an essay, which is an excerpt from my journal, as well as a poem. It's one of my favorites. And I could even do another one because I do have a fourth publication in this Bella Grace magazine, which came out 2 summers ago? Yeah. And last but not least, don't forget to subscribe by hitting that red button right there. We really are like one big family on my channel with lots of love to go around, and it's never too late to join. All you have to do is hit subscribe. Also, don't forget to click the bell. This notifies you every time I upload a new video, and I always shout out the first comment of my video on social media. So be sure to follow me, links in the description box, to see if you got that shout out. That's all I have to say. I will see you guys on Thursday with another new video. Bye! If you've been following my channel for a while, then you know that at 19, was I 19? In a small club in Minnesota, and the snow outside of First Ave, I just wanted my name and a star. Now look at where we at.